Once again, good morning, Green Spring. And you know, I shouldn't have said my childhood because I have a special guest mm-hmm. and it's involving her childhood as well. I have my coworker and beloved friend, Kelly Lukschander here. And you know, I know Green Spring loves our dynamic performance. And so we thought, you know what, let's do a movie show together.
Yeah.
And then you actually came up with the Disney Pixar theme.
Yeah.
Can you kind of tell why you chose that?
Yeah, so I wanted to do animated films because you said, you know, flashback to your childhood. But if you look at the list of films we're going to go through, a lot of them, one was even last year that you have on your list. So yeah. It's childhood, but it's also something I think that's fun for everyone, mm-hmm. animated films. And it'll just be nice to see a little flash of what we think is a good movie.
And you know, we kind of stuck to the Disney ones. To me, Pixar Disney films are amazing. They're for everyone from every age.
Yep.
Like, to me, what I like about them is the emotional draw.
Oh, yeah.
And the emotional, like, just tug that it does. I don't know what about
yeah.
for you.
I mean, for me, these animated films, like we were saying, they're aimed at kids, but they have these important storylines with love mm-hmm. and loss and all sorts of things that everyone can relate to. But I do have to confess, my first movie is not a Disney Pixar. It is a DreamWorks production. But
I'm sure Disney bought them out, so yeah. you know, it's all connected one way or another.
It's fine.
Yeah. So, okay, we're just going to jump right into yeah. it because we just love discussing and talking about these movie
sure.
clips. So the first one I chose is Tarzan, and I was giving you a
Ooh.
Little bit of a funny story. You know, my parents had no problem buying us DVDs and movies back in the day, mm-hmm. but the one movie my dad didn't want to get was Tarzan. And one of the reasons is because he didn't like monkeys.
Oh,
he doesn't like monkeys. He thinks they're like the worst animals out there. He thinks they're ugly.
Yeah.
He just, especially orangutans. He just thinks monkeys are awful. So this is a movie that when we saw it on TV, we
yeah.
all got excited because we didn't have the movie.
That's why.
To watch.
It's kind of like a taboo.
Exactly. So we have Tarzan. And if people don't know, Tarzan is the movie where a couple actually shipwrecks on an mm-hmm. island and then they die, but their child is left there and gets raised by apes. So let's see a clip of when Tarzan meets Jane. Awesome. And you know what's something interesting about that?
Yeah.
I remember one time my brother and I found some clip they were doing behind the scenes about that movie.
Mm.
You see how he slides on
yeah.
the trees? They actually had someone simulating skateboarding. And so they
cool.
took the movement of that and integrated, I guess, in their animation
yeah.
process. And so I just love that scene uh-huh. with the baboons chasing them, and
that's
I think
awesome.
It's totally cool. So
I loved it.
Yeah.
Yeah, the animation on that and the depths that you see, how high they go from that tree. Amazing. Well, now it's my turn. I'm
okay.
taking over. I'm going to talk about another, I think, kind of hideous creature that maybe your dad would have hated. But this is Shrek.
My
is
dad
one
loves
of my
Shrek.
Okay.
He loves Shrek.
Shrek is one of my favorites. It was made in 2001. It's a DreamWorks production, but it follows this nasty green ogre, Shrek, and his quest with this annoying donkey to go and save this queen from a dragon, and we find out later the queen has a bit of a secret herself. But I love that movie because it is packed with comedy, and I just watched it again recently. It's on Netflix for anyone who wants to watch it.
Oh, I didn't
know
that.
Yeah, and it has all these hidden, like, kind of adult-themed, like, jokes.
Mm-hmm.
So it's fun to watch again, and it has this all-star cast. It has Mike Myers, it has Eddie Murphy, Cameron Diaz, and John Lithgow, just to name a few. So let's watch a clip from Shrek.
I guess you don't entertain much, do you?
I like my privacy.
You know I do, too. That's another thing we have in common. Like, I hate it when you got somebody in your face, you trying to give them a hint and they won't leave, and then there's that big awkward silence, you know? Can I stay with you?
What?
Can I stay with you, please?
Of course!
Really?
No.
Please! I don't want to go back there. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well... maybe you do, but that's why we gotta stick together. You gotta let me stay, please, please.
Okay, okay, but one night only.
Ah, thank you.
Ah.
What do you know? Oh, no. This is gonna be fun. We can stay up late, swapping manly stories, and in the morning, I'm making waffles.
Oh,
where do I sleep?
Outside.
Oh, I guess that's cool. I mean, I don't know you, and you don't know me, so I guess outside is best, you know. Yeah, I go. Good night. I mean, I do like the outdoors. I'm a dunk. I was born outside. Sitting by myself outside.
It's so good watching it again. And a good fact about that movie, it won the Oscar for Best Animated Film in 2001.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that. You know, I was just telling you, even the donkey looks like Eddie Murphy in the eyes. You know, I wonder how they did that, because the entire time I'm looking like, I hear Eddie Murphy, and it looks like
you
Eddie Murphy.
You kind of see him.
But it's donkey.
Yep.
I enjoy that movie. My favorite part of that whole movie is when they save the princess out of the tower, mm-hmm. and then the donkey falls in love with the dragon, and that whole weird exchange. But we can stay on Shrek forever. The next movie I chose was A Bug's Life.
Mm.
And it's actually a pretty older movie. Yeah. I don't think a lot of people know about it. And it's pretty much a colony of ants mm-hmm. who are bullied and enslaved by grasshoppers to get them food.
Mm-hmm.
And there's one ant named Flick who is the only one to kind of be like, you know, why are we doing this?
Yeah.
You know. So I chose one of the scenes at the end of when Flick actually stands up to the grasshopper and kind of starts the revolution to be like, yo, like, get your own food.
Nice.
So let's take a look at that real quick.
Let this be a lesson to all you ants. Ideas are very dangerous things. You are mindless, soil-shoving losers. Put on this earth to serve us.
You're wrong, Hopper. Ants are not meant to serve grasshoppers. I've seen these ants do great things. And year after year, they somehow manage to pick food for themselves and you. So who is the weaker species? Ants don't serve grasshoppers. It's you who need us. We're a lot stronger than you say we are. And you know it, don't you?
I love the little suspense, so, you know, you gotta see
that.
What happens to Flick at the end. And, you know, I just thought of something. What I love about Disney movies is that there's a meaning and a point at the end. You know, imagine as a little kid, that teaches you, if there's a bully pushing you around, be bold to stand up for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what I appreciate about these movies. They give you a life lesson to implement in everyday life.
Absolutely, and looking back on them, like I haven't seen that movie probably since I was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think I've made that connection. And now I'm like, wow, I was really, you know, we were learning something.
Yeah, we were learning something, but you know, only Disney.
Only Disney.
Now this, we both agree on this,
this next one
coming
I think
up.
Everyone can agree has to go down on some sort of list. It's Toy Story.
Mm-hmm.
1995, this movie came out. It's a Disney movie, and it follows kind of toys. And what do they do when you're not around? They come to life. So it follows Woody, the main toy, and he lives with a little boy, Andy. And, you know, he's Andy's favorite toy, gets taken everywhere. Then one birthday, Andy gets a new toy. It's Buzz Lightyear. And so that becomes his new favorite. They don't really get along. But in the end, they end up having to band together when they are separated from Andy and want to get home before he moves away. Mm-hmm. So it's a good tale about friendship, and there's a lot of good stories in there. You know, you got a friend in me, you've probably heard that. So let's take a clip of when Woody meets Buzz Lightyear.
Kind of intelligent life, anyway.
Hello?
Oh, yeah! Ah! Whoa! Hey, whoa, 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 whoa. Did I frighten you? Didn't mean to. Sorry, howdy. My name is Woody, and this is Andy's room. That's all I wanted to say. And also, there has been a bit of a mix-up. This is my spot, see? The bed here.
Local law enforcement. It's about time you got here. I'm Buzz Lightyear, Space Ranger, Universe Protection Unit. My ship has crash-landed here by mistake.
Yes, it is a mistake, because you see, the bed here is my spot.
I need to repair my turbo boosters. Do people still use fossil fuels, or have you discovered crystallic fusion?
Well, let's see. We got...
Yeah, so there, Buzz Lightyear is a new toy. He doesn't really know that he's not a toy living on this space planet. So that's kind of funny. One thing I did find that I thought was interesting is this was the first animated film in Oscar history to be nominated for Best Screenplay. Because before 2001, I believe, they didn't have a Best Animated Film category. So they eventually had to make it because of this, you know, strong movies that Disney was bringing forward. So... I did have one more thing that I thought was interesting, too.
Go for it.
Tom Hanks, he's a voice there. He recorded a lot of his dialogue during breaks of Sleepless in Seattle when he was filming that in A League of Their Own because he was doing a bunch of other movies, too, like Philadelphia and Forrest Gump, but he didn't want to film in between so serious movies because he thought it would get him out of character to go back to this, like, kid role. So I thought that was just kind of interesting to know where they were at that time. So we have Tom Hanks, Tim Allen, Don Rickles. That's just an awesome, awesome movie.
Yes, so going along with the whole Toy Story train, our childhood came back to life when we got the news that Toy Story 3 was coming out. It's kind of like now with Incredibles 2 being in theaters, you know, all of us who were waiting to see what happened with the family. You know, I was so excited when I heard about Toy Story 3. And what happens in Toy Story 3 is Andy is now, I think he's going to college. And he's having to give away his toys. So the whole collection of toys from Toy Story 1 and 2 are now in this daycare center. And so as with little kids, they destroy the toys. And so there's this whole monopoly of being in a daycare and then the toys getting abused. And it's funny. And it still has that lighthearted feeling into it. And you have that love for those characters. And so I chose a scene of when Barbie interrogates Ken, the doll, and I just find it so hilarious of just how it got set up. So let's watch it, and then we'll talk more about it.
Trunks.
Oh, Barbie, those were vintage. It's okay. All right, go ahead. I don't care. They're a dime a dozen.
Ooh, glitter tacks.
Oh, who cares? Who cares? Sequins are tacky. Who cares?
Ooh, a Nehru jacket.
Barbie, not the Nehru.
This is from what? 1967?
The Groovy Formal Collection, yes!
What a shame.
Oh, no. No. No! 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 There's an instruction manual! Lots of switch buzz the demo mode!
Where's that manual?
It's a short clip, but I just love that part. I remember being in the theater, like, losing it. My friends were like, calm down. It's just such a weird... I would have never thought to have Ken and Barbie going at it like that.
It's so cute. And I have a feeling that that would be a way to get you to do something we wanted you to do. Start ripping up your clothes right in front of you.
No, ripping up my socks or throwing away Skittles. At, you know, doing something like that would probably get any answer out of me. But yes, Toy Story is probably it's probably the only one of the few movies I can say that has a 1, 2, and 3 series that remain good. All three of them remain good.
Do they have a 4?
I hear rumors that there might be a 4th, but you know, who knows? We might be 30. And
we welcome it, though.
Yeah, we'll go there. I don't care what age I'll be at the time.
Yep.
All right, let's keep going down the train.
All right, next one. This one I had to put in there. I know you might not agree with me, but I put in Moana, which was a 2016 Disney film, and I just had to. It is a beautiful story. It's kind of a first for Disney. This is a Polynesian cast for Disney. They had the directors do a lot of Polynesian research to make sure they followed the culture and the mythology correctly. But basically, it follows this young girl, Moana, who is basically is tasked, without knowing it, to go and save her community because they're not able to fish, and they live on this island and they can't have food anymore because, mm-hmm. you know, there's a bunch of other features that go on. But basically it's a story of this young girl having to save an entire community, which for me as a woman, it's really nice to see these strong female characters. Mm-hmm. So let's watch a clip from Moana when she meets her kind of sidekick, as it turns out to be. Let's see.
Ward, my
boat! A boat! The gods have given me a boat!
Maui, shapeshifter, demigod of the wind and sea, I am Moana.
Hero of men.
What?
It's actually Maui, shapeshifter, demigod of the wind and sea, hero of men. I interrupted from the top. Hero of men. Go.
I am
Sorry. And women. Men and women. Both. All. Not a guy-girl thing. You know, Maui is a hero to all. You're doing great.
What? No. I'm here to...
Oh, of course. Yes. Maui always has time for his fans. Mm-hmm. When you use a bird to write with, it's called tweeting. Eh? I know, not every day you get a chance to meet your hero.
You are not my hero, and I'm not here so you can sign my oar. I'm here because you stole the heart of Tefiti, and you will board my boat, sail across the sea, and put it back!
Love that. She is so fearless and mm-hmm. just awesome. And, you know, she does her thing, and I love that. And that movie also has a lot of nice songs in it. And if you know a little trivia, the creator of Hamilton, the musical, mm-hmm. Lin-Manuel Miranda, wrote the songs, and he's also in the film. So it's a fun watch.
Now, let me defend myself on okay. why I have the mm-hmm. opinion I have. I totally support strong female roles.
Yeah.
Like, I love that in today's culture, like, we have that mm-hmm. out there. And I love that Disney does diversity of yeah. different cultures and ethnicity. I just found the movie so boring.
Man.
It was just so boring.
Everyone watching, just give Moana a chance. It's fun, and it's nice because it's summer. Yeah. Watch a nice movie about the ocean.
Yeah, the ocean, you know, I say go out and, you know, watch it and see if you like it.
Yeah.
I just found it so boring.
Fair
it just
enough.
It didn't have that Disney drawing strings on me like the other ones did.
Well, so, what do you have next?
Well, speaking of diversity, so we're going to Japanese. Mm. So I chose Big Hero 6. And so okay. I remember I saw what a good college buddy of mine, he just randomly went like, yo, let's go to the movies. Mm. And then he paid for my ticket because it was around my birthday time.
Yeah.
And he picked this one. And I was like, why'd you pick a... Like, I didn't want to go see
a
this.
Kid movie.
Yeah, a kid movie. And I fell in love with this movie. So basically, I don't think... Have you seen this?
No, I haven't.
So basically, it's about this 10, 11-year-old boy. He's already graduated high school. Mm-hmm. He's super smart in engineering and robotics. Mm. So he, with his invention that yeah. he from his brother and that he upgraded, he creates a team that they take down a supervillain. And
cool.
there's actually a lot of comedy in it.
Nice.
And so the big, you see in the picture, the big one oh, in yeah. white, that is Betamax, which is the robot that he uses to help, you know, solve
Cute.
Crime, and that's his team. So it's just a fun cool. movie. It's nice seeing all the robotics and engineering mm-hmm. and stuff. You know, I used to be in that nerd side of liking that.
Used
you know,
to be.
Used to be. Because I used to be really into Legos and uh-huh. making things, you know, work like that.
Yeah.
So it kind of brought that back up.
That's cool.
When I was a kid. So let's check out the opening scene of when the main character is in a secret underground robo fight.
Hmm.
That was my first fight. Can I try again?
No one likes a sore loser, little boy. Go home.
I've got more money. Fighters ready? Fight!
Megabot, destroy.
Huh?
I like that.
Yeah, and so I told you earlier, funniest. I wanted to let the residents know how frugal I am. Mm-hmm. So this past weekend, I finally bought the movie because every time I wanted to buy it, it's like $15, $20. Mm-hmm. And so I went to Target with a good friend of mine, and I, of course, looked to see if they lowered the price.
Yeah.
And it was at $15, and I went like, no, I'm not paying $15 for this. So we went to this place called Second and Charles, which is basically like a used bookstore with movies. Mm-hmm. And so when I went there, I got it for $3.
Yeah.
So I'm so glad I didn't spend the $15 and I only paid $3. And
good
I love
you.
This movie. I highly recommend it.
I really like that. I've actually seen like those robot fights is like really mm-hmm. popular right now. I've seen a TV show even. I can't think of what it's called. It's mm-hmm. probably like robot fights. But that's interesting that they chose that and made a kids or animated movie out of it. Like,
yeah. I highly recommend it. Watch it. And, you know, like I said, it brought up that old Lego mm-hmm. Avan that I used to love building those
Very
all
cool.
the time. So, you know, I might get back into it.
Very cool.
All right.
Okay, my next movie, Inside Out.
Now, I haven't seen this one.
You have to see it. I can't talk more about this movie. Well, I would if we didn't have 10 minutes left in the show. But this is a 2015. Again, most of my movies are pretty recent. Mm-hmm. I still enjoy a good movie, animated movie. So with Inside Out, basically, it takes place inside the head of mm-hmm. the main character, which is Riley. She's a young girl. She's moved from her small town to San Francisco. And so it follows kind of all of her different emotions in her head. You have a different character for joy, you know, sadness, mm-hmm. Anger. So it's kind of cool to see, like, what goes on in my head when things are happening. Like, and I just love it because they show just, like, different parts of your life that really make you who you are. And it made me really reflect on myself and kind of say, oh, like, this is why I'm a goofball sometimes, because mm-hmm. when I was a kid, my parents would do this with me or something. So it's really a fun film. It has some sad moments, touching moments. But let's take a clip and look at what some of these emotions look like.
All right.
Here we go. All right, open.
This looks new.
Think it's safe?
What is it? Okay, caution. There is a dangerous smell, people. Hold on, what is that?
This is disgust. She basically keeps Riley from being poisoned, physically and socially.
That is not brightly colored or shaped like a dinosaur. Hold on, guys. It's broccoli! Yucky! Well, I just saved our lives. Ooh. Yeah, you're welcome.
Riley, if you don't eat your dinner, you're not gonna get any dessert.
Wait, did he just say we couldn't have dessert?
That's anger. He cares very deeply about things being fair.
So that's how you wanna play it, old man? No dessert? Oh, sure. We'll eat our dinner right after you eat this.
Riley, here comes an airplane.
Oh. Airplane. We got an airplane, everybody.
That and that's another Oscar winner. Oscar mm-hmm. for Best Nominated Movie in 2016. And they also kind of shaped the emotions to kind of look like things like that. Like mm-hmm. the anger was like a little fireball, and then the mm-hmm. sadness is a little like teardrop looking thing. So it's just fun to think about.
What were those little marble things?
So the little marbles are like your memories. And so they get stored in this bank. Yeah, it's really cool. And you can like see the memories in the ball.
So it's like from that memory, I reacted this way, mm-hmm. and this is why I am affected.
Yep. It's very cool. Like, you can see it and kind of be like, wow. So I recommend watching that. That is such a fun movie.
That sounds like a really
good movie. And has another good cast of all comedic actors. We have Amy Poehler. Mm-hmm. We have Kelly and Phyllis, who are characters from The Office, in there. So it's a lot of fun.
Yeah. So I am very excited about my next one.
Woohoo!
Me encanta esta película. I love mm-hmm. this movie coming up. So it's a Spanish. So we talked about how Disney movie does diversity of different cultures mm-hmm. and ethnicity. So they have their recent one called Coco, which is from a Mexican Latino background.
That's right.
And I love this movie. I saw it twice back to back. You know I'm learning Spanish.
Yep.
So first I watched it in English, and then I challenged myself in watching it in Spanish. I understood a lot of it, but there's still some points I didn't understand yet. But this movie was just amazing. I watched it just one day randomly on Netflix, you know, mm-hmm. just flipping through. I didn't want to watch The Office again, so I was like, Coco's on here. Let me watch it. And it's basically about this Latino boy who grew up in his family that always focused on work, work, work. And then they wanted nothing to do with music.
Yeah.
But he had a drawing to music, which comes from his grandfather mm-hmm. back in the day. And so there's a long family dynamic of why they don't like music, and I won't go into it. But they have that celebration, the Day of the Dead, right, where they honor their ancestors. So he taps in and goes into the other side of the dead,
yep,
and hangs out with them. And so he's trying to find his grandfather, mm-hmm, there to get his blessing to play music, because no one else would give it to him.
Yep.
So let's see the performance he did, Un Poco Loco.
Oh, yeah.
A little crazy, the song he did performing it.
What color is the sky? Ay, mi amor, you tell me that it's red. Ay, mi amor, where should I put my shoes? Ay, mi amor, you say put them on your head. Ay, mi amor, you make me un poco loco, un poquitito loco. The way you keep me guessing, I'm nodding and I'm guessing. Now count it as a blessing that I'm only un poco loco. Not bad for a dead guy.
Not so bad yourself, gordito.
Eso!
He's close. Find him.
The love that you make me, it is just un poco crazy. The sense that you're not making.
The liberties you're taking.
We're looking for a living kid, about 12.
Have you seen a living boy? I love that.
It's muy buena. It's such a good it's such a good movie.
It really
and
is.
I will say, out of I've seen several movies, mm-hmm, Disney movies, this probably had the best music going on.
Yeah, it, had
it just had me rocking, and it's such a good movie, and the ending was just tear jerking.
I've seen that movie too, and it is a wonderfully made film. And mm-hmm, I think it's interesting, you know, that Disney focuses on something like Day of the Dead or something, mm-hmm, that you wouldn't think is normally like a kid's subject or something like that. So for this character to be in this world of the dead is kind of awesome for, mm-hmm, for everyone. And it's really a cool thing. And it's a touching story about how we remember people who have passed away. So mm-hmm, I think it's beautiful. And the animation is like top notch.
And I will say, I know you got to go to your next film. It taught me a lot more about that holiday because I heard about it. And I always thought, oh, this is, I don't know. When I hear the Day of the Dead, I'm thinking, oh, this is
Halloween.
There's some witchcraft thing going on, like something freaky. But it's actually, like you said, it's honoring those who in your family that's passed on and just remembering their memory.
So it's a special film. Mm-hmm. So now I'll roll on to my favorite, which again is something that I think is interesting that Disney would focus on. And it focuses on those monsters that scare you at night. So as a kid, I'm sure you might have been scared. Mm-hmm. Oh, I got to check my closet before I go to bed. Well, this movie is Monsters, Inc. that I'm focusing on, and this is another 2001 Pixar film. And basically, it's in this town called Metropolis, which is just filled with monsters, and they power their town with electricity from children's screams. So these monsters are employed, and different doors of people come down every day, and they go into your closet through your door, scare you, get that scream, and move on. So I want to show a clip. It goes on a little bit further about how maybe humans aren't so bad monsters. Mm-hmm. We don't have to not get along. So there's a clip where a little kid named Boo accidentally gets out of her closet and enters into the monster world. So we're going to kind of see what that's like. Okay, not only is that movie really nicely animated, it's really cute, but one little fun fact I think you'll find interesting is, so that main big character there, his name's Sully, and he has all that fur, and it used to take 11 to 12 hours to render a single frame with him because each of the 2.3 million hairs were individually animated on his head. So if you watch it, they move beautifully. It's an awesome film. It has John Goodman, Billy Crystal, Steve Buscemi. So check it out if you want to, but I know we got to move on.
Yeah, I will say in editing world, video editing world, that rendering, basically, that computer was doing nothing else besides rendering the entire time.
Exactly.
Oh, I guess I can only imagine that editor being so frustrated having to wait the entire time.
Yep.
Well, it seems like our time is up. Kelly, this is sadly, I think, your last time you will be on Village in Motion.
It is, and I almost forgot we were having so much fun, but it's been great to be on Village in Motion, and I will hopefully be back, so don't count me out yet, everyone.
Oh, is this a to be continued?
And to be continued, but I will say quickly, I'm going to plug my own party. Right. We have a farewell to me coming up this Monday. You'll see a flyer on the bulletin boards, but it'll be Monday, July 9th in the Village Square Craft Room from 2 to 3:30. Just come say goodbye to me. Wish me some well wishes, I hope. And I'd like to share some last stories with people if I can. You know, I've really had an excellent time working here at Green Spring. So many stories.
I will say, Kelly, I have enjoyed working with you from the Eye on Green Springs, from the talent show, and just, what is it, Walking on Green Spring, the questionnaires.
We've
had a lot of good times. We were both young when we started.
I'm still young. You're still young.
I don't know. I'm 26. I'm getting close to 30.
Oh, yeah.
He's
really old.
I'm right there. I'm right there. But Kelly, we all love you.
Thank you.
We hope to see you come back.
I will be
and
back.
And say at least hello.
All I can say is I know there's a talent show in August, and that's all I can say.